I wish the person I like would notice me.
I only want the health of my children.
I hope to find a good job this year. We are so poor.
I wish to have a baby.
I wish my husband didn't have such trouble at work.
I hope life will be better for my brother and me next year.
Notice we're missing back at the orphanage, Oliver. We have to hurry. I'm sure this money bags will notice if we take some jewelry. I'll climb through here and open the door for you.
Wendy was naughty this year and must be punished. You were also very bad, boy. It's your turn.
Oliver, I'm Jack Frost, the spirit of winter fun. Your sister was taken by Berta, an evil spirit who punishes naughty children. But don't worry, you can save her. I have a magical artifact for you, the snowball of good deeds. It's empty now, but you can charge it up. Do 3 good deeds to fill the snowball. It'll help you defeat Berta and rescue your sister. This is the Dillinghams' house. They're in some trouble. I stopped time for them so you can help them. And don't forget, I'm watching out for you. Whenever you need me, I'll be there. Lucky you! That's no ordinary box. It holds a lot of mysteries. To reveal one, you need to place a special star on the lid. Thank you.
A lot of money went missing from my company safe. The loss was too big for me to make up. So I mortgaged our house and all our property without telling Della. I didn't raise the money to cover the debt. And now, they're going to take our house. How on earth can I tell my wife about this? I sold the watch I inherited from my father to buy a present for Della. The combs she so wanted for her beautiful hair. And now, I think it's time to tell Della the truth.
Friend, can I admit something to you? I used to be Berta's servant. I did some evil things. Not at all like a real elf. But I want to change. Let me be your friend and helper.
Jim doesn't think I know about his problems at work, but it's pretty obvious. Jim is wonderful. He's always so kind to others, but he's too proud to ask for help for himself. To cheer him up, I've decided to sell my hair to buy a beautiful chain for his family watch.
Could have stolen his money. You're in big trouble with your first good deed, little boy.
Chop, chop!
I really appreciate your help. But look what that evil elf turned the figurine into. I worked all night just to finish it for my customer. Please help me fix it. If we work together, it won't take much time. As soon as the figurine is restored, I'll try to help you with whatever you need.
Thank you.
Oh, I feel terrible for the Dillinghams. Jim is a good friend. He helped me open this shop. I owe him a lot. That's more money than I can afford. I can only give you half. But there is someone who might be able to help with the rest. Our friend, Alex Wilson. Alex doesn't trust a lot of people. But if you bring me a paper and quill, I'll write him a note so he'll help you. Hurry, young lad. Together, we just might help the Dillinghams have a Merry Christmas after all.
Hello, Oliver. I see Michael trusts you. In that case, so do I. I'm afraid I'm in trouble, though. My daughter, Chloe, is missing. This is her favorite toy. Will you help me find her?
Thank you.
Care to join your sister, Oliver?
Big trouble. I took my dad's brooch to play with it and it broke. I can't go back home without it. He'll be so mad. Help me.
Chloe!
Chloe.
A huge help. Now we can head back to my dad.
My Chloe is back. Thank you. I'm always willing to help, Jim. I'll give you the rest of the money. The Dillinghams are good people. I'd hate to see them suffer on Christmas Day.
The Dillinghams will be just fine now. Jim and Della really love each other. And they have great friends who wanted to help them in their time of need. That's what I call Christmas spirit.
A pretty toy for my tree. Oh, but you must be lonely. Don't worry, there's still plenty of room for your brother.
I never doubted that you could help the Dillinghams, Oliver. I'd like to present you with a piece of magic power for your sphere. But there's another person in this town who desperately needs your help. My magic can send you there, but you must find them and help them on your own.
This tailor shop is the legacy of my family, passing from father to son for many generations. Now it's time for me to take over Dad's shop, but recently, we haven't been getting any orders. I'm worried. I finally got an order from a local rich man. He wanted a finely embroidered caftan. He provided everything, even gemstones and golden thread. I set to work immediately. The unthinkable has happened. All my supplies have disappeared, and I don't have enough money to replace them. The deadline is tomorrow, but I have nothing to show my client. What if he shuts down my business? Will my cat Simkin and I lose our home? I'm not giving up. I've run all over town gathering supplies for the caftan. There must be some spare buttons and thread in my shop as well. I need to restore my caftan sketch. I tore it to pieces last night in a fit of despair. I've got everything but the golden clasps. My neighbor, the jeweler, has some, but they're too expensive. Father raised me to treat others with respect, kindness, and love. I've never offended anyone, not even a mouse. But yet, I still ended up like this. I've ruined my father's shop, and I've disgraced my family. I could use some kindness myself.
Lose something, Peter?
Thank you.
Hey, Oliver. I think you need this Mother Mouse's help more than mine right now. If you don't mind, I'll just wait for you here. Good luck.
Hmm?
Thank you.
Peter's life is about to change. You've breathed new life into his family business. Peter will become world-renowned for his intricate stitches. Almost like they were made by mice. Next, I'll transfer you to a special place to help one more very special family. The person who needs your help is the one who isn't waiting for you.
Hello, dear. You must be the messenger. I'm Abigail, and I live here alone. Would you mind doing a little favor for an ailing old woman? You see, I've misplaced a very important box in my house. It has three letters inside it. Here's my spare house key. Please, find the box and my letters.
You've gone too far, Oliver, but you're in luck. Jack's protecting you. Even so, I'll turn this house and its silent inhabitants against you!
Okay. My husband and I yearned for a child of our own. One Christmas, I made that wish with all my heart. Our wish came true. That following year, I gave birth to our son. He was such a courageous and daring boy, which earned him many friends. I loved all of his friends, except for that troublemaker, a neighbor boy named Matt. Is it possible I sensed what was to come? One day, my son and Matt were playing in the woods when they met an evil woman. My son distracted her while Matt ran for help. My son was chased deep into the forest until he fell into a deep pit. He couldn't climb out. The whole town gathered to search for him, but that night the temperature dropped severely. When we finally found him, it was too late. You found it. Thank you. I have one more request. I was visiting my son, but I left his photo album behind. Here is a map to my son's memorial. Please, my son's photo album is my most treasured memory of him. And if it's not too much trouble, could you tidy up a bit? Just put a new photo in the frame, and put a toy and a Christmas treat on the memorial.
Thank you.
Now you know my story. I'm Jack, Abigail's son. After I died protecting my friend, I was given the chance to live a new life as the spirit of Christmas, mischief, and fun. Unfortunately, only children can see me. Every winter I check on my mother, but she's so sad and lonely. You've helped so much. Here's the photo album. Don't worry, my mother is a strong lady. Go on, I'll meet you back there.
Thank you, dear. I feel so much better. This angel was Jack's favorite toy. I thought I'd lost it. I can almost feel him right beside me again. Thank you.
I'll stay here with my mother. Here's your reward. Now go! Save your sister!
You've saved me some trouble by bringing yourself to my lair. Soon you'll take your place on my tree, next to your sister.
Wendy, I have a very special surprise for you. Close your eyes. No peeking. I just couldn't return you to the orphanage, so I want you to have my family. You can stay here with Abigail if you like. And so, that's how three lonely hearts united as a new family. They're so happy, and that's what's really important. My job here is done. All that's left is to wish you all a Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year, too.